Do you remember who Monica is? Saint Monica? It was the mother of Augustine. That's her son, Augustine, was in his early life a reprobate. He just wasn't good at all. He was diving into the worst things, and Monica spent her whole life praying for her son, that God would allow him to lift his eyes up off of the temporal and to see the ever-glorious vision of Jesus himself. And finally, Augustine did. He turned into a very godly man. And this is what he says about our predicament called life in this world. He said, "Men are hopeless creatures. And the less they concentrate on their own sins, the more interested they become in the sins of others. They seek to criticize, not to correct, and are unable to excuse themselves. And because they are ready to accuse others. Jesus speaks of beholding the speck of wood in your brother's eye while ignoring the old growth redwood log in your own eye. If you want God's mercy, just give it to others. For with the same measure that ye meet withal, it shall be measured unto you," our Lord tells us. Now, here's great news. There is within us the gift that alleviates the power of suffering. Doesn't get rid of it, but it alleviates its power. And the Romans tells us what it is in the epistle this day. "I reckon that the sufferings of this present time are not worthy to be compared with the glory which shall be revealed in us." It was so with John the Baptist and all the saints of the church. What's the gift? Well, the Christian hope of everlasting life. We get a little bit of that right now in our life here. When we love God and our neighbor and we show mercy to one another. And then we get the whole kit and caboodle in life with God in the end. That's mercy. And it is spelled J-E-S-U-S.